Alright, so here is the situation, guys. Your boy Tiger is literally one day away from reaching 1,000 total login days on Global and finally getting my hands on that coveted LR Spirit Bomb Goku that I've been wanting for a very, very long time. I mean, ever since he was first announced, basically, which was a long time ago. So clearly, this is a super, super exciting thing for me. But at the same time, I thought the timing was perfect to make an updated video about all the major login rewards that all Dokkan players can expect between days 1 to 1500 of playing this game. And without further ado, let's just jump right into it because there's a lot of stuff to cover. I don't want this video to be too long. So we're gonna start here with the cumulative login bonus first, and then we'll talk about the consecutive login bonus as well because they are different. And one of them is actually significantly better than the other one, as you guys will see in just a second. But starting with the cumulative login bonus first, I would say on average, the daily rewards you're getting from this are actually kinda underwhelming, I'm not gonna lie. I mean, of course, as you can see, when you first start the game from day 1 until like day 10, they give you a pretty decent amount of stones because I think Bandai just wants to show that they're very generous, you know? They want to keep you in it. They want to be like, yo, look at us, we're giving you so many stones for the first couple days. So between days 1 to 10, you're getting about 15 dragon stones, and then things kind of trail off from there. In general, I would say the pattern is every 2 to 3 days, you get one dragon stone from your cumulative login bonus, but then the other days, you're looking at some awakening medals, you're looking at some training items, some support items, and so on and so forth. Basically a bunch of crap, and then a dragon stone, and then a bunch more crap, and then another dragon stone, and that's kind of the general pattern. Of course, there are some special days in between, some milestones, like every 100 days you'll get something special, every all the days that have like repeating numbers like 111 or 222, 333, so on and so forth are also special days for special rewards. And there's also 1,000 days, of course, there's 500 days, there's 1 year, and all that good stuff. So we'll get to that in just a second. But before we go to that, let's talk about this consecutive login bonus, which is just a huge disappointment, guys. I mean, for how hard it is to keep a long streak, because, you know, like, people get busy, right? Like, things come up in life, maybe you go on a trip, maybe you break your phone or something like that, I don't really know. But for any number of reasons, people can miss a day here or there, right? So it's really hard to have a consecutive login bonus of, like, more than a couple hundred days. I mean, I've seen some people with, like, 1200, 1300, even 1500 day consecutive login. It's very impressive, but let me show you real quick what you get for logging in consecutively for up to 1500 days, all right? Friend points and Zenny. That's pretty much it, and it's not even a lot of it, man. It's literally like a couple hundred friend points and a couple hundred Zenny, all right? Or a couple thousand Zenny, rather. So let's say you log in every single day for 1550 days straight. Like, you played the game every single day for literally 4+ years. You are getting, for your consecutive login bonus, 500 friend points. Yeah, I mean, they could have done better. I really think they could have done better. I don't understand why they couldn't at least, like, make the big milestones like 1,000 days consecutive or 1,500 days, 500 days consecutive, special, or like 1 year consecutive. No matter what day you're looking at, it's always friend points, it's always Zenny, and it just goes back and forth forever. Okay, I mean, it really doesn't matter that much in the grand scheme of things. It's just a little gripe I've had with Bandai for a while now, and I had to get it out there in this video. But those are the consecutive login bonuses. Like I said, guys, they're absolute garbage. So don't worry too much about losing a consecutive streak if you have to miss a day here and there. It really doesn't affect you in any way. And the main thing to focus on is definitely the cumulative or total login days. All right, so with those out of the way, let's talk about the significant rewards for your cumulative login bonuses. And for that, we're gonna go down here to the major login milestones. So we're not going to go through everything, but we're just going to quickly highlight the big things. All right, so like I said, for the first couple days, you're getting quite a few stones just because Bandai wants to show their generosity and keep you playing the game. And then from there on out for 30 days or 1 month, you get 3 stones plus one of each of the Kai medals. And these are actually really good when you first start out because they're pretty rare. And I remember like when I first started playing this game, I always ran out of the Supreme Kai and Elder Kai medals. So that's pretty nice. And then for 50 days, which I guess is significant because it's half of 100, you get 5 stones. And then for 100 days, you get 5 more stones. And so on and so forth. Like I said, for days with repeating numbers, you get a few more stones. But for 111, we get 3 stones. For 150, we get 5 stones. And 5 stones for a couple of other significant days. I actually don't know what 229 is special for, or like why it's a special day, but apparently for day 229, we also get 5 more stones. For a quarter of 1,000, we get 5 stones. And then we get to a really big day, which is 1 year. And for this, we get 10 Dragon Stones, 3 Elder Kais, and a bunch of other crap. But let's be real, the only thing we really care about are the stones and the Kais. And to be honest, even though 10 stones are nice, I feel like they could have done better. I feel like we could have gotten at least like, I don't know, a multi for playing the game for one whole year. I mean, that's a pretty big deal, right? You're only going to hit 1 year, one time in your entire career of playing this game. So I feel like 10 stones is a little bit cheap, Bandai, but I guess it's better than nothing. So for 1 year, we get a lot of other stuff. I mean, I guess maybe they think that giving us this other stuff is going to make up for the lack of stones, but I mean, it doesn't. It really doesn't. So that's for 1 year. That's kind of the first big reward we get. And then for day 400, we get 7 stones, 444, 5 stones, like I said, repeating numbers are always significant days. And then for day 500, we can expect an absolutely massive haul of 30 Dragon Stones. And I know it kind of sounds like I'm being a little sarcastic there, which I might be, but for the most part, I actually feel like 30 stones is quite a generous offering from Bandai, and I do appreciate it. And this is actually the largest amount of stones we can get at once for any given login bonus day, at least for the ones we know about. There is one other day that also gives 30, but never more than that. So day 500, definitely a very significant day for login bonuses, and definitely one you want to keep your eye out for, especially if you're close. And as far as I'm aware, the only significance to this day is that it's half of 1,000. So day 500, it's a big day, 30 stones for that, pretty freaking awesome. And now let's move on to 501 to 1,000. So the first special day here is day 510, where we get an R-Goten and also 10 Dragon Stones. Now for anybody that is confused about why we get the R-Goten, apparently from what I've been told, 5 in Japanese is Go, and then obviously 10 is 10 in English. So you combine those two, you get Goten. So day 510 is essentially Goten day, and that's why we get the R-Goten and also the 10 stones. And then for day 580, we're getting 8 Dragon Stones as well as 58 Grandpa Gohan medals. And the reasoning behind this day is that once again, 5 is Go, and then apparently 8 in Japanese sounds like Han. So the number 58 is usually associated with Gohan, and that explains the 58 Grandpa Gohan medals. And I really like the fact that they basically dedicated this day to Grandpa Gohan as opposed to Goku's son Gohan, since I feel like this man definitely deserves a lot more respect than the average fan gives him. I mean, after all, he was Goku's original master, right? So that explains day 590, or 580 rather. And then for day 590, we're getting 9 Dragon Stones and some Ghost Ushers and some other stuff. And once again, this is another one of those name pun things. Bandai seems to really like them. So 5 is Go, 9 in Japanese kind of sounds like Ku. So 5-9 is Goku, and that's why we're getting stuff for that. And then for day 600, we get 10 stones. Like I said, every 100 days is considered a milestone, so we do get extra rewards for those days, as well as consecutive number days like 666, we get 5 stones. 700 days, we get 10 stones. And then the next three are pretty interesting. So for day 737, we get the AGL Goku as well as 3 stones. For 753, we get Tech Piccolo and 3 stones. And for 757, we get STR Gohan and 3 stones. And the reasoning behind this is quite interesting. I'm gonna scroll down here a little bit. So for day 737, we get Goku because Goku was born in age 737. And then for day 753, Piccolo was born on May 9th, age 753. So that's why we get him. And then once again, as you guessed, Gohan is born in age 757, which is why we get him for day 757. So a nice bit of Dragon Ball trivia right there for anybody that didn't know. I honestly was not aware about this or aware of this until I saw this, so I guess I'm not a hardcore Dragon Ball fan, even though I feel like I am. But anyways, nice trivia for anybody that didn't know. And then for day 777, we get the oh-so-infamous AGL Hercule, the best card in the entire game, obviously. 777 Baba points, and also 7,777,777 Zenny, which at the time this was released, maybe was considered a lot of Zenny. I don't really remember, but the main thing that caught my attention that actually got me a little heated, I'm not gonna lie, is the fact that Global gets 7 Dragon Stones from this, which, you know, fits the theme of 7s, but JP gets 30 Dragon Stones, guys. 30 stones versus 7 stones. And as much as I don't like to play too much into the, you know, Global shafted, like JP is the favorite child or whatever, Bandai argument, I don't like to talk about it too much. I mean, how can you explain this? How do you explain 23 less stones on Global for day 777? I mean, I've heard that the number 7 is like the lucky number in Japan, and that's why, you know, it's such a significant number in Dokkan, right? But still, like, you don't have to give JP more stones just because of that. I mean, number 7 is actually a very lucky number in a lot of countries around the world, right? And I know a lot of people consider 7 to be their lucky number, so I just don't feel like it makes sense. I really don't. I don't get why JP gets 23 more stones on this day compared to Global. It's just, it's not cool, Bandai. It's not cool, man. If there's a Bandai spy out there, please fix this. And for anybody that reached 777 and passed it on Global, just give us like 23 stones for compensation and we'll be good to go, all right? Just putting that out there. I mean, it's ridiculous. It really is. Okay. So we're going to move on from this. This Hercule is trash, but he is a nice item to have, like a collector's item. I actually rainbowed this guy just for fun, and he does like 5 damage. Okay, next up, day 800 is 10 stones, 818 is 3 stones. I don't really remember the significance of this unless it's for Android 18 maybe, but I'm not really sure. Day 888 is definitely for Android 8 or 8er, so we got 5 stones and 8 haters for that. And then 900 is 10 stones, 999 is 9 stones, as well as some Zenny and Baba points. And finally, we're at the day that I'm gonna reach literally tomorrow, day 1000. Dragonstone wise, a little bit lacking, I'm not gonna lie, a little bit disappointing, only 10 Dragonstones when we get 30 for day 500. But I think this more than makes up for it. 5 copies of the LR Spirit Bomb Goku, which of course is just enough to rainbow him. And this is the only way to get him, guys. You can't summon him on a banner. You can't buy him in the Baba Shop. The only way to get this LR Goku is to play the game for a total of 1,000 days. And he is appropriately named Thousandfold Plea Goku. And for a free-to-play LR, he is actually a very good unit, guys. I mean, of course, he's not as good as any of the summonable LRs, but for a free-to-play unit, he is very, very solid. And he also happens to have, in my opinion, one of the best card arts in the entire game, guys. I mean, if not number one, then easily in the top 3 or top 5, which is a very nice bonus. And as far as his details go, he gives all types ki plus 3, HP, attack, and defense plus 100%, so you can basically build any team you want with him. And his super attacks are Spirit Bomb for the 12 key, Super Spirit Bomb for the 18 key. 12 key causes colossal damage and raises allies' attack by 20% for one turn. And the 18 key causes mega colossal damage and raises allies' attack and defense by 25% for one turn. And his passive is attack plus 77% plus an additional attack and defense plus 7% and recovers 7,777 HP per key sphere obtained. So he's a nuker, and he also is a very, very good healer. And links are okay, they're not the best, but they're not bad. And then categories are Majin Buu Saga, Pure Saiyans, and Goku's family. So that is the LR Spirit Bomb Goku that you get for free upon 1,000 days of playing the game. And he's really good. He's really, really good. Okay, so that's the guy I'm gonna be getting in one day, as I've said multiple times in this video. I'm super, super excited for it. And that is pretty much the biggest login reward you can expect from this game, but there's still some more stuff beyond that, so let's move on to 101 or 1001 to 1500 days. And we're getting close to the current like number of days that have passed since Dokkan came out. And as you can see, there's nothing too crazy beyond 1000 days. There are still some days where you get a lot of stones, like 1100, 1200. For 1318, you get 3 stones, 1 stones, and 8 stones. And when I first saw that, I was like, that's kind of weird. Like, I don't really understand what the point of that is. Why don't they just give us, you know, 12 stones at once instead of breaking it up? And then I realized that March 18th is actually technically Saiyan Day, so that's why 1318 is a special day, and that's why they broke it up into 318. So that's 12 stones for Saiyan Day right there. And also for 1500 days, we're getting 15 stones and 1 Grand Kai of each type. 1111 is 11 stones. I feel like they could have given us more stones for that, but it's fine, it's fine. And then for every, you know, 100 days beyond 1500, it's 10 stones, a Kai, which I'll take, another 10 stones and a Kai for 1400 days. And then between 1501 to 2000, there's nothing here because, like I said, we're getting pretty close to the current day and there's nothing really too significant. Yet, I expect the next like really, really big login reward that we'll hear about is 2000 days. I actually don't know how far we are from it, but you guys can rest assured that once news comes out about that, once we get close to it, and we have some information about what the 2000 day login bonus will be, whether it's a new LR or, I don't know, like 100 stones or something like that, I'll definitely keep you guys posted in a future video. But that's pretty much gonna do it for today's video, guys. I know it was super long, like I said in the beginning of this video, there's a lot of stuff to get through, but hopefully you guys learned something from this video, whether it's some trivia about which day some characters were born, or the meaning behind like certain numbers and names and stuff like that. Yeah, that's all I really gotta say. Hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Hope you guys are looking forward to all these login rewards that are coming up. If you guys are still fairly new players, and even if you're not, maybe you've been playing for like 490 days, then you're getting a good amount of stones in just 10 days on day 500 for 30 stones. So yeah guys, that's gonna do it for today's video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I am super, super hyped, like I said, for my LR Goku in one day, and I felt like the timing was perfect to make this video, so here we are. And until more information comes out about future big login bonuses, I probably won't make another video like this for a while. But as always, if you guys enjoyed today's video, then make sure to like the damn video. And if it's your first time watching me, first time to the channel, and you like what you see, then definitely hit that big red subscribe button to join the Tiger Squad now. And while you're at it, hit that notification bell too, so that YouTube knows you want to stay up to date with all my latest content. And that's it. I'm out of here. Until next time, I hope you guys have a fantastic, fantastic day. I'm Tiger with Tiger Uppercut Media. Signing out.